by Dennis Lawrence. He gets it up to York. York gets it out to Stern John. Stern John plays it in the middle. Dennis Lawrence is free. The tall defender is going on goal. He's onside. Has a chance to score the man. Dennis scores it in the goal. Scores! Dennis Lawrence, the man from Wrexham, has done it for TNT.
We thank you for being here with us for today's official pre-game press briefing ahead of Friday's World Cup qualifier between Trinidad and Tobago and Panama. With me at the head table is head coach of our men's senior team, coach Dennis Lawrence. He's going to give an opening remark, and then obviously we open the floor to questions pertaining to Friday's opening qualifying game, opening game with respect to coach Dennis Lawrence's first game in charge of a senior men's team in World Cup qualification. Coach Lawrence, obviously you've had your full contingent players are here and preparations are fully on stream.
Good day, gentlemen. So far all the boys have arrived safe and sound, which is the most important thing. I think they've all come in, they've all showed a good spirit so far. They've all started working. We started to work immediately from when the boys and them arrived. We've still got a day and a half more or less to go before the big game. I think the most important thing was to try and balance the scale and making sure that we had the recovery right from the journeys, because some of the boys arrived late in the night. We've managed to do that so far. We've integrated them by spending a lot of time working on and off the football pitch. Take no notice of what you see on the tactics board. So I think that's where we are at the moment. We've got another session this afternoon and we've got one more tomorrow, and the preparation continues.
So we have a first question for Coach Lawrence. I'll just indicate your name and name of media house.
Giovanni Mello from Flow Sports. Coach, I know last time we spoke to you, you said that you were trying to do certain things with the locally based players. How easy or how hard has it been to get the foreign based players onto your program?
At the moment so far, they've come in and they've tried to take things on board. Obviously, I've got a shorter period of time with them. Some of them, Levi only arrived yesterday, Sheldon arrived this morning. So it's going to be a bit shorter for these players, but the work needs to be done, and hopefully they'll take enough on board to go into the game on Friday.
Next question.
Coach, today's Wednesday, the game kicks off 7 p.m. on Friday. How will you say on the set ratio, how ready is the team for Panama at this point in time?
The team has to be ready 100% come Friday. The preparation at the moment, as I said before, is still continuing. The most main important thing is to make sure that come Friday at 7 p.m. they're ready. These boys have come in. Some of them have had a couple games under the belt. There's a couple of them who actually weren't involved with the club team for whatever reason. They're here now. What I've liked from the ones who probably wasn't involved enough, they've come in with a certain hunger. I think they're all here. They've got a bit of anger in them about the situations at the club, and we need to benefit from that. So the most main important thing is come Friday night at 7 p.m., the boys need to be 100% ready on that to take that football pitch.
We've seen a lot that Kenwin Jones is a polarizing figure, especially from the fan base. Do you have any comments based on that and with regards to why you selected him for the squad?
Kenwin is a player that I think everybody needs to understand. Kenwin has been around Trinidad and Tobago football for a long while. Kenwin has come here and he's come to do what I've asked him to do, to come and represent his country again. When players are in the moments and the periods that Kenwin is in, Kenwin needs support from the Trinidad and Tobago fans. Kenwin needs support from the people around him. My job is to help Kenwin and to prepare Kenwin to perform on the match day. My belief is that Kenwin has got a lot to offer Trinidad and Tobago football. I see a path for Kenwin to play with Trinidad and Tobago football, and I think he deserves the opportunity to be given the chance, and that's why I selected Kenwin.
Just
still yet to decide on that. What I've done is, as I said, from day one when I started to assess the group. I've had the full contingent of the players that come from abroad now, and I'm still assessing the group. It's not a decision that I'm in any rush to make. I'm going to make the decision up to the last moment. So I'm still assessing the group over the next 2 days, and the captain will be announced on the day of the game. What I would like to do is, I'd love to win the game, and I think we all understand that if we don't win the game, then we mustn't lose the game, because one of the most important things is if we can, for whatever reason, come out with 4 points, which is, if we can win this one and get one against Mexico, great. If we get one here and we get three against Mexico, great. So either way or the other, the most main important thing is we mustn't lose the game. 6 points would be brilliant. 3-3.
On the subject of leadership, in previous matches you've seen that sometimes when things don't go to plan, the plan kind of goes out the window.
Yeah.
How do you address what some may call a crisis of leadership on the bench?
I think the most important thing is what I tried to explain to the group is, we are now going to try to do things in a way that I'm not sure a lot of them was asked to do. We need to believe in what we're going to do. We have prepared for this game. We are continuing the preparations. We have to believe in what we're going to do. If we, for whatever reason, try to go away from what we are good at, then we put ourselves in a difficult situation. So the most main important thing is for me to express to the players, we have to believe in what we're going to do. We have to commit to it, and we have to carry it out for 90 minutes. If there's any changes that need to be made, it will be made amongst myself. But then the most main important thing is, the players are the more intelligent ones. They are the ones that are on the pitch. They would be the ones that would see what is required at the moment in time. And what I would be hoping is that they would make the right decision. So the ownership is on to them to some point, but we're going to have direction in how we're going to try and approach the game to get a result. I think any sort of experience, especially in these circumstances, is great. I think the more important people involved in that would be Kenwin and Carlos, because they're in and amongst the group more than I am. What I've tried to express to the guys in them is that what we did in 2005 and 2006 is fantastic. It's history. That's where it is. But I now want these players to create their own history. I want history for these players and them to become and say, right, we're here, and we want to take up the mantle, and we want to take Trinidad and Tobago to another level. So I've given ownership to them now that what we've done is never to be forgotten. But at this moment in time, it's not really important. It's what they do now to take us forward. That's what I'm interested in.
Further questions, Coach? Go ahead.
I'm Ashwin Chaudhary with Major League Soccer. How great of an advantage is it to you as a coach to have a contingent coming from MLS, some of whom are playing at a very good level right now?
I think it's always good to have the added experience of having the foreign-based players in, because in most cases, not all, but in most cases, the foreign players always work at a higher level because of, obviously, the equipment that they have, to their availability, the environment that they're working under. So I'm hoping that when they come, they would bring that extra bit to add to what the local players and them have offered. Now, what I would say is, I had the group of the local players, I had them from the 20th, and they took on board everything that I wanted them to do. I had to make a selection process in the end, and I had to say to some of them that they're not going to be involved for these two games only, because what we've started, it must continue. And it was very, very difficult for me, very, very difficult, because I thought to myself that some of them really, really did well. But at the end, I had to select the best possible team I thought would be what I would need to go into these two games. So having the extra experience of the players coming from abroad, whether it be the MLS, the boys who come from Lithuania, Russia, Holland, I think it should be an added bonus to the group.
As you mentioned, the local players recently, they had a World Cup game. What did you see out of that game, and were they able to play the way you wanted to play?
One of the things that, when I spoke about after the game, that I was very pleased about is the manner they tried to maintain possession of the ball. Obviously, I felt in the second half that, look, we could have done a little bit more better. We could have been a bit more brave and try and go and get the third goal and the fourth goal. But that was expected, because I kind of understood they would take the possession, as I said, just trying to keep the ball. So I was really, really pleased with the manner in that they went out to try and maintain possession of the ball, to try and take a bit more control in the game. What I'm going to do from this group is I'm expecting the same type of performance, and I'm expecting them to come in and be able to progress what we did against Barbados. So that's the idea at the moment. I think the idea is for us to play in the same manner, with the same mentality, that we need to try and get on the ball as much as possible and see how much control of the game we're going to take. Obviously, there was a few things in the Barbados game that had to be corrected, because I think playing Barbados, with no disrespect, but trying to play against higher opposition, things can cost us, so we had to adjust a few things. So, but the mindset is going to be the same thing. We need to try as best as possible to see how we can manage the game by seeing if we can have a little bit more possession of the ball.
Go ahead, Pastor.
All right, Coach. Seeing that this is your first World Cup qualifier, the pressure of the importance of getting out of the result, pressure from the fans, and everything, for everything to go right, are you feeling pressure at this moment?
No, because I'm not pressured, because I think the work that I'm trying to do, I've got direction in the work that I'm doing. I've got a philosophy in my head, and I've got clear direction what I want to do. I think sometimes if you don't have direction, you can feel pressured. So the most main important thing to me is to stay focused, to work on the things that I believe that we're going to do to get a result. And the pressure from the outside must not affect me, because if it affects me, it affects the players. So the only thing I can control is what we do in this room here as a group with the players. And that's all I'm going to be focused on.
Coach, do you for instance, approach the game against Panama any different from maybe against CONCACAF or outside Mexico, or is it the same?
At this moment in time, the only thing I can focus on is Panama. When the Panama game's finished, then I'll branch over to Mexico. What I've done is I've tried to put together video clips of the opposition. I've tried to work on things on the training pitch. I've tried to work on things on the tactics board. So the only thing we can do is go into the Panama game knowing exactly what we would like to do and just focus on that. It's been very good. And the reason why it's been very good is when I selected the coaching staff, I wanted people who believed in what I wanted to do. And I've managed to put together that group. I wanted people around me that I can trust, people around me that I was comfortable to work with. And these people have come in. Now, don't take it for granted that when you talk about somebody as Sol Campbell, this guy's a winner. Now, we have a mentality here that I thought needed to change a bit. And Sol was part of the process in doing that. Sol's a winner. We have got this inferior complex at times to the bigger nations. I wanted to try and change that. I thought the best way to do it is to integrate somebody with that sort of winning mentality into the group, so then it can spiral down the channel. So from that point of view, I think the staff has been very, very good in what I've asked them to do. The staff have been very enthusiastic, and the players have responded well to the staff. So from that point of view, I'm very happy with the way I was going with the staff.
One of the complaints of the Barbados match was that the team, while they were keeping possession, didn't know what to do with the ball at certain times. How much creative control have you been able to instill into your players in going forward and even when they have the ball?
Yeah, it wasn't so much that we choose not to be creative. I think we just lost a bit of direction in terms of when we were keeping the ball, what was the purpose we were keeping the ball for. And I'm not too sure if whether having the 2-goal lead, they felt that, well, we've got the 2 goals, so there was no need to go after the third. So the only thing I've just tried to say to them is we need to take advantage of the opportunity, and that the possession must try and always end with a result. You must try to always think about taking that possession into becoming opportunities. So we've just tried to correct that a little bit. And as I said before, the group has come in. We've tried to do it. Hopefully, come Friday, they're going to execute it. If it doesn't, I would still understand, because as I said before, I'm going to ask them to do things. I'm not sure that the clubs they're playing or whether they were asked to do it before. But that's the idea.
Go ahead, Joel.
Yes, I know the question was asked before, but have you made a captain?
No.
Not as yet. Been named on match day. Further questions for head coach? TV6? Any questions?
The training sessions have been very positive. The group has come in and the energies they have showed, the enthusiasm, the wanting to be back to represent Trinidad has been very, very good. What I think I've tried to do with the boys, I've tried to use different techniques to try and get them to integrate as quick as possible. I think they've taken on board. What I try to do is assess them in and around on the training pitch, off the training pitch, and so far they've all seemed to gel together. They've all seemed to be pulling in the same direction, and that's the only thing I can ask on them in the moment.
You've heard that Panama has had some players that's coming across from Colombia. What sort of difference in play do you expect from them?
I think Panama is going to play exactly the way they play. They're going to be very, very well organized. They're going to make themselves very, very tough to beat. They're a very competitive group. And we need to understand that the first thing we need to match with them is their desire. Because they're a team that plays with the heart, and they're a team that look hungry. They look like a hungry bunch. And we need to match that first and foremost. And then when we match that, then we would like to hope that whatever qualities we've got after that would be enough. But we've got to match their intensity. We've got to match their hunger, their endeavor to try and win games. So that's the first thing we're going to do. I hope so, because if they can't, then we'll be struggling. So the idea is we've worked, we've tried to prepare physically in the best possible way to ensure that it can go 90 minutes. So the idea is now I'm confident that we'll be able to do it.
And then there's a shorter period to relax before the Mexico game. Are you confident that you have a deep enough bench to take on Mexico for a period of time?
We get past Panama. We've got 26 players in camp. I think bringing the 26 players in camp was for a reason. I think it gave us the opportunity to be able to have that as an option. But what I don't want the players to be doing is thinking about Mexico. The only thing I want them to be doing is thinking about giving every single thing against Panama. And then when we get past the Panama, we then go on to Mexico.
One more, go ahead.
So you've experienced World Cup qualifying as a player. What are the challenges of the Hex and the importance of winning the home games in this style of tournament?
I think it's huge. I think if you look at when we did it, I think we won three at home and we managed to pick up one on the road. So I think everybody understands the importance of playing at home and taking advantage of the home environment. So that's why I'm trying to encourage everyone to let's try and put a positive spin on this. Let's try and come together as a nation and make sure that, look, let's give Panama the understanding that they're not in Panama and that they're here in Trinidad and Tobago.
Okay, we have a final question for John.
At this moment in time, we've got no injury concerns, which is a good thing, and hopefully it stays that way.
Okay, members of the press, we thank you for being here with us today. This evening's training session is closed. Tomorrow we open it back up for you guys to attend. I will advise you of the training time. We train at 7 p.m. at Hazy Crawford Stadium tomorrow. So it's open for media, at least for the first 15 minutes. All right, thank you for being here with us.
Thank you.
Thank you, Coach.